with the now famous walkout on The View, where Whoopi and Joy left the live show in protest of Bill O'Reilly's comments on Muslims. Well, here's NBC's Peter Alexander and the wild TV moment and how the debate continued on their primetime shows.
Please welcome Bill O'Reilly.
It all started when The View's hot topics boiled over.
But it's inappropriate because a lot of the 9/11 families, who I know, say, look, we don't want that.
This is America.
Hold it, hold it. Listen to me, because you'll learn.
Was impressed, and O'Reilly wasn't finished.
So 70% of Americans don't want that mosque down there, so don't give me the
weakness.
Why are we saying inappropriate?
Why is it inappropriate when 70 families died?
Why did you do this on 9/11?
No! Yeah. Oh, my God!
Outraged, both Whoopi Goldberg and Joy Behar stormed off the set, leaving their co-hosts and guests on Barbara Walters, the show's creator, was critical of Goldberg and Behar's action.
You have just seen what should not happen. We should be able to have discussions without washing our hands and screaming and walking off stage.
But then Walters took on O'Reilly.
Now, let me just say to you in a calmer voice, it was extremist. You cannot take a whole religion and demean them.
You should apologize.
You've got to make a distinction.
Anybody felt that I was demeaning all Muslims.
Yes, Bill O'Reilly is a firebrand on the right. Joy Behar is a firebrand on the left. The whole point of putting the two of them on a couch together is to make sparks fly. And when that happened on Thursday's episode of The View, everybody got lucky.
After O'Reilly's apology, Goldberg and Behar finally returned.
No one I know, no one wants to insult Muslims.
But the drama continued on cable TV.
I enjoyed jousting with the View ladies because, with the exception of Elizabeth Hasselbeck, they don't see it my way, and I want their audience to hear both sides. I love that exposition today. Didn't you?
I saw O'Reilly. I thought he was saying something that I construe as hate speech, frankly.
The latest round in what's already an angry national debate.
Peter Alexander reporting, and Nora, you say, good for Whoopi and Joy for walking out in the middle of that. Why do you say that?
Well, I support the women walking off because they didn't feel like it was a debate. I think they felt like they were being bullied by O'Reilly. I support Whoopi and Joy.
I mean, for me, I guess what I would say is there's a core issue here, which is there is a small group of well-funded Wahhabi extremists funded by the Saudi Arabian government to whom we give money. You invite me on the show, what's going to happen, okay? It is American oil money and American guns to the Saudi Arabian government. Those guns, that money, to Wahhabi extremist Muslims in Saudi Arabia, the only ones who have ever killed us, them. We are not at war with Islam. We are not at war with Muslims. We are not at war with Afghanistan. We are not at war with Iraq, Iran. It's nonsense. So yes, they hold signs, I hate America. Have you seen the signs we hold? The only people that have ever funded a terrorist attack out of that part of the world on us, on your colleagues and your colleagues and your colleagues 9 years ago, was this Wahhabi sect, and it is an extraordinary failure of our politicians and our media and our anybody else who has an opportunity to communicate information to fail to make that distinction, because to fail to make that distinction is to risk a scale of conflict and a scale of disenfranchisement and alienation on this planet that may be convenient for TV ratings and votes, but is an abomination for the human beings who will populate this planet, and it's a lie.
So you have referenced, to my mind, the most valid point that Bill O'Reilly made, and it is that in the wake of everything that has occurred around the world since September 11th and before September,
yes,
the coal bombing,
yes,
the leadership of the Muslim world has remained uniquely silent about what has happened. I mean, you get no encyclical from the Muslim world.
Because ultimately, think about the dynamic in the Muslim world. That the Muslim world, you have different factions that are trying to retain their power relative to other factions within that community. And that includes factions that do not want to see Saudi strength rise, or that don't want to see Iranian strength rise and see Iranian strength as something that can be balanced through other forces. But that's beside the point, which is, in my opinion, which is that whether it's leadership in the Middle East or leadership in America, the failure to make the distinction between the Wahhabi sect that is funded through Saudi money and all other Islam, period. Even, I don't care whether it's Islam or I'm angry saying I hate Americans, you got a sign. Like I said, go to Ground Zero, go to Florida, I'll show you some signs. Are we since when are we going to go to war over a sign?
Well, I was just going to say, though, to that argument, you know, you could say any group that's trying to protect themselves is always uniquely silent. Say that about the Catholic Church was uniquely silent. Uh-huh. They need to be. My issue with this, we talked around this in the last 3 hours, two of the hours I was awake for. But what's interesting is that, to me, it's more about, Dylan, you make that point about ratings, is that it's Bill O'Reilly going on the
politician
to talk about this so they can go back to the respective shows and talk about it. And even us, we talk about it. It's interesting television, but it's almost like this unique sort of ecosphere where we're just feeding each other, and nobody, Oprah's going on the Daily Show with Colbert. I mean, it's just us talking about us talking about us.
But there's a real issue, which is
there is a real issue.
The information distortion and the fear-mongering and the amount of money and the amount of power that can be accumulated in this country and other countries through the distortion and exploitation of religious fear and racial fear in exchange for having decent, honest exchange of real information, which is, you know what, most Muslims don't even care about you. And the vast majority of the ones that don't like you from the couch, and there aren't that many of them. And the ones that actually want to kill you, about this many, and it's not because they're Muslim, it's because they've been radicalized, and they have been, the religion has been used as a teaching mechanism as sure as Christianity or any other religion could be, but it is not the fact that they are Muslims that makes them terrorists. It is the fact that they are terrorists that makes them terrorists. And that is a massive distinction that I think has been uniformly not made in this country, because I think it strikes to the cognitive dissonance of these huge wars. We're not at war with Islam. Well, then would somebody please tell me why it is we're a few trillion dollars up and we've got a few thousand dead soldiers to fight all these wars in all these Middle Eastern countries? Because I thought we were at war with Islam, which is why we've got all these tanks and Predator drones flying everywhere. If we're just at war with a narrow group of well-funded, well-organized extremists out of Saudi Arabia and in that region, well, then can somebody please explain, it's tough to explain the policies in that context. If we're at war with Islam, if we're at war with the Muslims, well, then my goodness, I mean, there's got to be 10 more countries we've got to go to war with, right? It's an obscene concept, and it's shameful to me that anybody, from the president down, doesn't make an extraordinarily strong distinction between those two things.